Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your host, Kanan Gill!
Thank you guys for coming and welcome to Netflix's very own talk show, the brand new show, right here on YouTube.
Oh, I had the worst dream. I dreamt that I was doing marketing for Netflix.
Oh, Netflix, they're the worst. Oh. It's okay though, man, it was just a dream.
Thanks, man. Jim, I love you.
Hey, I love you. I love you.
I had the worst dream. I dreamt I was in bed with Kanan Gill.
Oh yeah? That was your worst dream?
Oh, no, I don't...
No, that's your...
I don't mean it like that.
How do you mean it then, Jim?
I mean it like...
How do you mean it?
I mean it, it's terrifying, you know, to see
what?
Your face as the first
you're
thing in the
making,
morning.
You're not making it better.
Why don't you go back to your mother's house?
Mother's house.
Oh, I had this terrible dream. That Jim had this terrible dream, that I had a terrible dream, that I was doing a show for Netflix, and then we were fighting.
Yes. And then we were, Kanan Gill, huh? And then you fell asleep 2 minutes later. Oh. What are you doing in my bed?
This is my bed.
This is my bed. My bed. My bed.
Oh, well, this is fine.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for your host, Kanan Gill!
All right! Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, wow, you're clapping like I asked you to. Okay, that proves that it was fake, by the way, that you stopped the moment I said, okay, bus. Thank you guys for coming and welcome to Netflix's very own talk show, the brand new show, right here on YouTube. Yeah. Why not on Netflix? Because we want people to watch it. But I'm not here to make fun of Netflix, really I'm not. I'm here to make fun of a particular film on Netflix. That film is Drive. Also known as The Fast and the Fast Forward, this movie. The plot is Ocean's 11 meets Fast and the Furious met Karan Johar at a party. So I have to make a movie, so make it. Do you want to hear the plot or anything? No, no, banao. I don't pay you for plots. I don't pay you at all. Don't worry if you're worried. I asked Netflix if I could make fun of their show, and they said no. So let's say positive things. Positive things like, you know, Drive doesn't have any plot holes because you need to have a plot to have plot holes. You could say that Drive is like a piece of modern art. Yeah, nobody knows what's happening, but it looks expensive. Drive is also fighting piracy by being so fuck all that no one will download it. And so instead of Netflix and chill, Drive pioneers the very new Netflix and chillao. At your TV, kya ho raha hai? What is the plot? Who is stealing from who? Who is getting out of a car in slow motion? Peeche look. Actually, you know, this is a true story. Netflix said, say what you want, and we'll just cut out the things that we don't like. And you know what I said to that? That's what I said. That's what I said. You know, globally, Netflix has an iconic sound. Yeah? And when you hear that sound, you expect something, right? Something cool is about to happen. And so maybe for India, we need to customize this sound. Instead of, perhaps we should have a more Indian. We came up with many variants. Try this. How about? That's my favorite. All right. Well, in all seriousness, Netflix does have some great Indian shows like Sacred Games. Sacred Games, you guys like Sacred Games? That was sick. It was an amazing show. It made me remember how good Saif is as an actor, right? He does such a great job in the show. And he plays a Sardar. And like being from a Sikh family, I really appreciated that he did a good job portraying that. Actually, I grew up in South India. So my identity is like, are you South Indian? Are you North Indian? Because my name is also like Kanan Gill, so they're like, where is it from? And, oh, sorry, I lost track. You know, like Sacred Game Season 2? Sure, there are some not so great shows, but there are some amazing ones as well, like Mindhunter, an American Vandal, and like every good comedy special in the whole world. So the moral of the story is, why do you deserve good content? What is so great about you? Tum bada ukhaad rahe ho job mein. How was your appraisal? Amazing? I don't think so. Yet you come home and you're like, I want best only. So you should watch shows with the good and the bad, yeah? Celebrate the good, celebrate the bad also. Appreciate it. Also, I have a comedy special coming out next year on Netflix. It's called Yours Sincerely and it's very good, so please watch it. Thank you. We've got a great show for you guys tonight. The cast of House Arrest is in the studio. So please give a huge round of applause and welcome on stage Shriya Pilgaonkar and Barkha Singh. Thank you for coming. Hi.
Hi, Kanan.
Hi.
Hi, Kanan.
Hi, Kanan.
Hi, Kanan.
Hi, Kanan.
Oh, my God. Thank you guys for coming. That's
that was
wonderful.
That was our moment where we just wanted to tell you that we loved the
pretentious movie review.
You forgot the name?
That See, sounds I like cruel. Huh? I loved it.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for both of you for coming. And Jim Sarbh is also in, of course, house arrest, but yes. He couldn't be here because he had something else to do. But he's here with us in spirit, actually.
Oh.
So, Mois, can we bring Jim?
You're kidding,
let's,
right?
Let's make place for Jim.
Hey, Jim.
Jim is sitting on my dress. Jim, stop sitting on my dress. Yeah.
We've actually got a very sophisticated artificial intelligence system that's going to model what Jim would have said.
Hi, Shriya. Hi, Barkha.
Hi, Jim.
Hi, Jim.
Insane. And this is like not AI. It thinks it's real.
I am a real person. I am a human being. Jim Sarbh.
That Your sounds legitimate.
Acting
right?
skills are so good that we believe you, Jim.
Yeah, it sounds pretty legit. Jim actually had to go for a play that he's acting in. But you guys, have you done any theater in your time?
I still do theater.
You still do theater?
Yeah. In fact, that's one thing that's common between Ali, Jim, and I, that we all started doing theater. And I don't know if Ali's still doing it, but I try and do as much as I can, although it's reduced. So I love the stage.
Yeah. Have you done college theater?
Yeah. But what? Like it was only till college. I did Ithaca.
Oh, Ithaca.
It would be
weird if you did college theater after college also.
No, I mean it ended there. My stint with theater sadly ended there.
Yeah, same here. I played a tree once.
That was sick. I played a wave.
You played a wave?
Yeah. How did you play a wave?
Oh, got it.
What was the play about?
I'm joking, of course not.
Oh, okay.
Hey.
Oh. No, I was.
Hey, I'm an actor here.
I was serious about the tree. I was the lead.
The first play I ever did was in the fourth grade. It was called Dilnaz and the Chocolate Cake.
Okay.
I was playing Dilnaz, and the only reason I did that play was because we used to rehearse with real chocolate cake
of
every
course.
Time. Real chocolate cake. So that was
shit.
My incentive to really go for rehearsal every single
time. We actually
time.
Have chocolate here if you guys want it.
It doesn't look.
It, I actually don't know if it's real or not.
Yeah.
We also have like chalk if you guys are into that.
Yeah. Maybe not anymore.
Not anymore? Okay. We would like to add a disclaimer that please don't do this at home.
Dude, do you like eating chalk?
I love eating
chalk. I love
chalk,
eating
but
chalk.
But I had to
too.
Stop because it gives me headaches now.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I'm just going to like.
Yeah, go for it.
I think we should
is
all.
Is it tasty?
For
is
old
nice?
Times' sake.
Let's try
it. It's not one of the better chalks. Like.
Let's see.
It's actually not.
Yeah.
It's not the nom nom.
This one. Is anyone? Real chalk. Are you kidding me? I thought this was one of those like, you know those...
Phantom.
Those... Kanan, you're weird.
I said it was chalk. What part
but
of it
But you ate it like it was some candy.
That was... Yeah. You did ever eat chalk in school?
Maybe perhaps like once growing up, but not... I wasn't like... relishing it like you are right now.
I used to steal. Oh my god.
That's okay, it's mine.
Drink it again?
Yeah, sure.
That's allowed.
This
That's
is not
allowed.
That gross. It's mine only.
Yeah, it's his. I agree.
Yeah. Even for somebody else's, honestly, like. If I know them or I've met them in passing, I think it's enough. Do you ever do that? I had this strategy, like when we were younger, like my parents wouldn't buy us Pepsi like very often, so we would get it at like a wedding or something. And so my sister and I had a strategy for like how to make Pepsi last. We broke it down. Yeah, it's going where you're thinking it's going. What's good about drinking like a soft drink? It's the taste of it in your mouth, not related to swallowing it. So we used to take Pepsi in our mouth and then just put it back. And that infinite Pepsi, in fact, the quantity increases over time. And it acquires a frothy texture. No one did this, it's just me. Okay, let's just... have you guys shot anything here before in this studio?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah, must have. What was it?
It was an ad for soap brands. It was a lot of like, ah, meri twacha, and all of that.
I've done like one or two ads. I really don't like it.
Soap ad?
Not a soap ad. Thank God. Something worse.
Deodorant?
Shadi.com.
Yeah. So have I.
Have you? Oh, shit! House Arrest is already out, and
yes.
I haven't had a chance to watch it yet, but it's supposed to be. The story, the concept is pretty insane.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
You've been shooting in a house the entire time. How long was the shoot? How long were you guys?
25, 26, 27 days.
And it's just one location, right? You're just in a house?
Yeah.
And there must be a green screen because you have...
No.
Yeah, I mean, some portions...
Sorry, Jim.
He was like, my scenes. Yeah.
Some portions we did shoot... like with green screen because we were trying to establish characters that weren't in the house, but they were appearing. So yeah, it's a really interesting concept, and it depends what you take from it.
Specifically, it's about a Japanese concept that it explores called hikikomori, which is people who are shut-ins from society.
You just answered it.
That is the setup. I think the thing that's missing, that's keeping most of us going outside, is the need for money.
But
if I could shoot this in my house, by the way, which I pitched really strongly, I'd be like, won't it be funny if I stayed at home only? And then we shot the whole show at home and we got audience members at home, and won't that be funny? And nobody said yes. And so we've come once again to this place. And then, Barkha, what do you play in the film?
The troublemaker.
Whatever clips I've seen, it's like your character's so annoying.
It's obnoxious.
But it must be so much fun to play an annoying character.
Yeah. It was fun, yeah, because like you don't get to be that obnoxious.
Yeah.
But when you're paid to be that obnoxious on Netflix, hell yeah, man.
Yeah. Are you guys working on another project right now that you can talk about?
Not that I can talk about.
Okay, cool. Can I guess?
Sure.
No, I can't. It's definitely not a matrimonial site.
No.
What about you, Shriya? Are you working on anything?
I'm just wrapping shoot for a film, which is my Tamil Telugu debut with Rana Dagupati.
Nice.
Yeah. It's called Hathi Mere Saathi.
The Hathi Mere Saathi?
No, it's the title is that. It's not, I mean, close to that film, but it's the first time I'll be speaking Tamil Telugu. So every scene actually we shot in Hindi, Tamil and Telugu.
Oh, that's
so it was a huge learning experience.
But I heard both of you like traveling. You're big fans. Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Have you been to Berlin?
I'm going.
Yes.
You're going?
I'm going.
Oh,
New Year's, yeah.
New Year's?
Yeah.
It's going to be cold as shit.
I've always wanted to experience like the Christmas there, you know.
So Berlin, you're going next. Do you have any plans coming up?
Yes.
Mm.
I might be doing a trip to LA.
Okay.
That's a work
Sounds like
trip.
Business.
No, but actually what I'm really excited about, again, fingers crossed, I'm not sure if it's going to work out, but I'm going to go to the African wilderness.
In LA?
It's
beautiful. No, in Africa.
Okay.
It's lovely.
I know, I'm really excited. I've never been to...
Sorry, Jim.
I've never been to...
He's a human being.
Sorry, Jim. He's still not stopped smiling, so that's a good thing. He didn't
get he's in a really good mood today. Okay, so you're going to the African wilderness. That's amazing. You have a YouTube channel as well, which I didn't know about.
Yeah, like a lot of people don't know about it.
Well, okay, you should go and follow. You know the game. Like, share, and subscribe. What's the name of the channel?
Barkha Singh.
Oh, it's just...
I'm very, very, you know, creative.
You didn't have a cool one like Barkha Speaks.
There's a hashtag travel with B.
Travel with B? All right. Barkha, it says here, in school and college, you've been quite the prankster. Is this true or is this...
It's very true.
In what way?
Let's put it this way. I've spent more time sitting outside the class than sitting in class.
Wait, because you were sent out or you just didn't go?
I was sent out.
Okay, cool.
I mean, even till the 10th grade when I was a captain and shit, I was made to sit outside the class. In fact, once my teacher accused me of snorting cocaine, I think.
What?
What? In what class?
I'm telling you, my school life was quite crazy.
It's a pretty strong accusation.
I was eating Jaljeera. I swear. I was at the last bench and like eating Jaljeera there, and my teacher
you
comes
were licking the Jaljeera.
No, I was just like this,
just
eating Jaljeera. No. It was like this. And she caught me. And the way she describes to my mom at the parent-teacher meeting, she's like, I saw your daughter with some white powder around her mouth. And my mom's like, bitter.
Let's see what Jim thinks about this story.
You're funny, hey.
Does Jim have any more jokes?
Jim actually has a joke.
A policeman stopped a drunk driver. The policeman said, how high are you? The man replied, it's high. How are you?
We're going to play a game in just a little bit. But before that, we need to set up and I have to take a quick bathroom break. So will you guys allow me 2 seconds?
Sure.
All right. See you in a bit. No. No.
Oh, hey.
No.
How do you like the show so far?
Business is business, Mr. Singhania. Now the ball is in your court. Please, ball wapas kar do, huh? What now?
What now? What's happening to us, Kanan? We don't talk anymore.
Oh, we're doing this again.
Don't talk to me this way. Is a little support too much to expect?
Damn it, I'm here doing high-powered business for us. Who do you think got this Netflix deal?
Wow, you're undermining my career just because you made the call? Classic Kanan. Classic Kanan.
Wait a minute. Shouldn't I be the one getting angry because you had a dream about Jim Sarbh?
But can you blame me? He's hot!
Man's not lying.
That is besides the point.
Wait, you think you got this gig? Why? Because of your jokes?
Yeh business ki dunya hai, Kanan. Yahan sirf paisa bolta hai.
They don't want you, Kanan. They want me, Kanan.
Huh? That's what I said. They want me, Kanan. Look. This isn't going anywhere. And you know, at the end of the day, you're still the most special person in my life. And you're the most special person in my life.
What are you doing with that?
Lekin.
Listen, man, we can talk
about it. Special abhi shoot ho chuka.
We can talk, man. I'll do anything. Please. No. I'll do.
Okay. Now we're going to play a game. Don't worry about this. This is just from, I had to meet a friend earlier. The game is called Bollywood versus Cringe. The game is pretty simple. In front of both of you are cards. You must read out the dialogue on the card. Now the person who's reading out the dialogue cannot break or smile in any way. The person who's listening to the dialogue must ascertain whether this is from an actual Bollywood movie or is it a fake dialogue that we have made up. Sounds right?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds fair? If you are wrong or you laugh, the penalty is you get sticker on your face.
Okay.
And the stickers are bleak. For example,
wait.
Pimple popper. Veg biryani. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, are we ready to start?
Yes.
Okay, Barkha, will you start?
Yes, I will.
Go for it.
Do you promise to stand, like, keep this away, maybe? It's making me a little nervous.
No problem.
मैंने भरे महफिल में शेर मारा तो शेरनी विधवा हो गई.
It's a film dialogue.
You are correct. Very good. Didn't break.
So we keep
excellent it here. Acting. It's from Chashme Badu. Oh. All right, Shriya, you're up next.
रख बाल खड़े, मसल बड़े और दही बड़े. तब जाके लड़की पटी.
Real or cringe?
Cringe.
You are absolutely correct. That is a fake line. Made up by the many talented writers that work on this show. Next up, Barkha.
बदन पे घी लगा के आई हो क्या? मैं ऊपर देखता हूँ, अपने आप नीचे नजर फिसल जाती है.
Cringe.
It's real.
It's real.
Yeah.
Is this cutting kya?
It's from Tum Mere Ho, a movie. Dialogue said by, I think, by Aamir Khan.
It's a great dialogue.
So now you get to pick a sticker?
For me.
Yes. And you get to put it on your face wherever you like.
What is it?
It says, you know what? It's best if you don't know what it says.
I want to know what it says.
Can you give a nice look to camera? All right, your turn. Really make it count. You need to return this sticker.
तर दिलों के कम हो जाते हैं मैं और तुम अगर रम हो जाते क्रिंज
यू आर करेक्ट
इट्स टू इजी
या आई मीन
व्हाट इज दिस इट्स टू इजी
We were writing, we're like, these are not absurd enough, the fake dialogues we're making up. But okay, okay, it'll pick up. Now, we're getting to the real shit. All right, Barkha, you're leading like crazy in this game. By one sticker.
Abhi to sirf chhua hai. Aur leak ho gaya. Tera pen.
It's a dialogue.
You are correct. Okay, it's from Dirty Picture. All right. You're still in this.
Okay.
You can get it back.
मैं तुम्हें अपने करीब रखूंगा बिल्कुल पैन की जिप की तरह
real.
I'm sorry, that's some we made up. You got it wrong! Oh! Which means that you get to have your revenge. Please pick a sticker. Okay, come on, let's do this. We're almost at the end.
तुझे समझाना जैसे हाथी को चड्डी पहनाना.
What?
Putting I don't get it.
Okay, I laughed, but you still have to make the determination.
Tell me again. तुझे समझाना जैसे हाथी को चड्डी पहनाना है.
It's a dialogue.
It's from Rangoon. Well done!
Okay, your turn?
Oh, yes. प्यार अगर पैंट है तो दोस्ती चड्डी है पैंट अगर फट भी जाए तो चड्डी इज्जत बचाती
है It's a real film dialogue.
You are correct. Chashme Badur, apparently.
Need to rewatch your Chashme Badur?
I think it's a new one. Okay, the game is still very, very neck and neck.
Okay. Pad.
This is over already. This is gone. But still finished.
अच्छा. Pad और बेवफा लड़की दोनों को छोड़ देना चाहिए.
I think this is a film dialogue. It would be a good dialogue if it's a film dialogue.
Unfortunately, this is a dialogue we have made up.
But it's a good dialogue.
Okay, so both of you got a sticker. You laughed and you were wrong. So.
Where any preference?
I mean, go for it. Yeah. And just okay. Because you're like.
Yeah, just because.
Yeah, sure. Why not? इस दुनिया में ईमानदार लगूंगा कोई नहीं है.
अरे, सिर्फ बटन ही दबाएगी क्या हमसे?
It's real.
It's from जवानी दीवानी. It's Imran Hashmi's dialogue. We're down to our last cards. Everything can change. Two stickers each. Audience is tense.
केले और लड़की में फर्क जानते हो? आदमी तो दोनों पे ही फिसलते हैं. मगर केला सेहत के लिए अच्छा होता है.
I think it's a film dialogue.
Unfortunately, we have made it up.
These are dialogues that you all should copyright because very good.
Okay, we are down to our one last. Oh, Jim deserves one. Aww, how sweet.
Because he's out of comebacks.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
Not this chalk again. Are you eating the chalk again?
No.
Okay. Holi khelne ka shauk hai, par teri pichkari mein dam nahi.
It's real.
Unfortunately, it is real.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it is real. Bonus points if either of you can tell where it's from.
Golmaal Returns.
Dirty picture.
Ah.
Has anyone been keeping track? Do I measure it in stickers?
But I've clearly like lost because I have more on me.
No, I have.
That's actually true.
Yeah.
Actually, in the game of guessing Bollywood or cringe dialogue, no one wins. And on that note, thank you for watching the brand new show. Can we have a huge round of applause for Shriya Pilgaonkar, Barkha Singh, Jim Sarbh Spirit. My name has been Kanan Gill. Thank you guys so much. Have a good night. And that's the end of the show. Now it's the brand old show. But another brand new show will come soon with a brand new host in a brand new branded shirt that he paid for. Come back. Fun hoga. Until then, like, share and subscribe. And please don't bribe. Yeah.